Hi guys, today quick and easy look at this thing. So it is a fuse panel from a MiG fighter, either MiG 21, 23 or something like this. So it is located in the fuselage. The pilot cannot access it in flight. It is behind a panel in the fuselage, so it is for ground maintenance only. So the aircraft have several of them, more or less big. So this is a quite small one. I have another one which is a little bigger, but it is exactly the same setup, exactly the same look. So this one was easier for me to bring out of storage. So what do we have? We have a bunch of fuse holders. We have connectors here at the side. The box is made of some kind of fiberglass material. And around each fuse you can see there is the amperage and the device. It is protecting. This one is for RSBN device. KM DA200, so it means something. The fuses are quite weird. So here is the fuse holder cover, you can see nice shape. There is some thing written on it, DPV in Cyrillic. It is as always the brown Amberton Bakelite material. Here is what the fuse look like inside. And it seems, yes, this is silver coated. So spare no expense, quite nice quality. So I believe the fuse are special form factor, so it is not a regular fuse you can buy off the shelf. Special for this purpose. So we have two more of them here on the side. Here are some locating pins and here are fasteners holes for screwing the panel in the aircraft frame. On the back we have this cover with screws all around preventing to see the insides. So I will remove the screws and I will be back. Here we are. I will lift this panel now. If I did not forget a screw somewhere, no. There is a seal, yes. So here is what we have inside. So yes, this is some kind of fiberglass. Very light, but very, very strong. And here is what we have inside. So as you can see, lot of wires, pretty neat wiring here, and relays, and also a big contactor. Let's zoom in. So here we can see the backside of the fuse holders. There is a nut, as you can see, around with some kind of castle shape nut to keep them in place. Here are the connectors. You can see each wire here has a heat shrink piece with its number written on it. Here we have a big contactor, power contactor. With these three contacts, it seems. Maybe more even. Quite a big one. You can see it is bolted in place on this vertical piece here. I have a few of these contactors as spare parts, but this one is bigger than the other ones I have, I believe. And here at the bottom we have relays. You can see pretty regular one, big ones, but regular shape. There are some smaller ones all at the bottom here. And one more here, a big one. This relay here is a metal body. And it is almost all. You can see the big thick wires here have cloth insulator. I believe it is cloth, and behind the cloth you have a regular PVC insulator. These ones are PVC. You can see the handmade wire lacing, of course. And on the border here, we have some gunk, so it seems it was sealed with silicone. So here we are. One more thing, it is interesting, look at these little stickers. For each part has its number, in fact. With a little sticker, and it looks like almost they were made by a writing machine, and they were hand cut and hand glued in place. Pretty interesting. Yes, look, the shape is not regular on the sticker, so it seems it was hand cut with scissors and glued in place one at a time. Down at the bottom here, probably it was not easy. There are some all at the back here behind. So really, oh, I did not see this. Yes, we have more relays here. This one have a round body. Let me see if I can find it. Light, yes. It is a round body, and you can see the wires here go in this plastic cap with some gunk in them. Not sure why it should be necessary to put gunk on these wires and not on the other ones. Quite weird. Because at the bottom here we just have in fact more relays. This one have a round case, not rectangular, but they are just relays, probably. Yes, according to their model number, they are relays. So do we have any dead code on this? Not easy to find a dead code. I have one back there. You will not be able to see it, but there is one. Here it is written, it is really not easy to work with this thing. 78. So it is late 70s. Vintage. Okay, so these panels are located in the fuselage under the cockpit, in fact, in the MiG aircraft. So you have a series of panels in the lower cockpit part. You can remove, and as you can see, the shape, in fact, they have is designed for fitting in there. Here, you can see this part here is for accommodating the cockpit section curve, in fact. Not sure it was very clear, but it is why they have some special shape sometimes. Okay. There is some thing written here on a panel. Must be for 36 volts, something. Here is a close-up at the devices numbers on the fuse for you. Here is BN, SAY, KM, KZA. So they are all regular flight equipment references, I believe. Okay, so here is your screenshot, your computer background for the day, maybe. So, thanks for watching. Bye bye.